Let's take a look at the pre-built character class now that's a part of what comes with Java. So public class character fun, public static void main string args. And if we have a character, once we've isolated a character, so I'll just do char ch equals and then just put something in there, a. Okay. Once I have that character, there may be times where I want to check to see, for example, if it's a letter or a number. Well, how do you do that with code? Well, there are some ways to do it, but we don't need to because somebody else has already done it for us. So in this set of character classes, there's a function. Well, I'll pull it up here. So character Java class. So in this character class, we've got some fields. Let's scroll down to the methods. So we've got these methods, and these are all the things we can do with the character class. Again, this is something that's been built by somebody, and there's all this functionality built into it that allows us to get information about characters, manipulate the characters, lots of different things we can do. But one of those things is to say, is it a letter? So isLetter is one of the methods. If we click on this, we pass in a character and we ask it, or we call this method, is it a letter? We give it the character and then it returns to us a Boolean. And guess what the Boolean is going to say? Well, it's going to return true if the character is a letter or false otherwise. If it's something other than a letter, then it's going to return a false. So let's try and use this. So I want to check to see if a character is a letter. Okay, so I'll say if, and now how do I get that method? Well, if I just say isLetter and then pass it the ch, and I'll print out system.out.println, yes, comma, this is a letter. If I try to compile and run this, I'm going to get an error saying cannot find symbol. I have no idea what you're talking about with this isLetter method. Well, that's because in my program there is no isLetter method. It's not part of my class, it's part of the character class. So I need to refer to the character class, which sits out in the system files for Java that you installed to be able to run these programs. So the character class has a method called isLetter. We're going to pass it ch, which holds an a, and we're going to check to see if it's a letter. If it is a letter, then we'll print out, yes, it is a letter. If otherwise, so if we get a false back, then I'll print out, no, this isn't a letter. Okay, so now we'll run this program. And it says, yes, this is a letter. Okay, the a that we are looking at is a letter. What if I put a capital A? Yes, that's a letter too. What if I put a question mark? No, this isn't a letter because this statement was false. It returned a false. The isLetter method went and checked using the ch that you passed it, the character that you passed it. And it returned a false, so that means that this statement is not true. This won't get executed, but rather the else will get executed, right? So put some periods on here. So now if I do a number, the number one, then no, that's not a letter. But if I run this again, well, then it will give me the same thing. If I do a letter and I say Z, yes, this is a letter. Okay, and that's all based on this pre-built method in this pre-built class, the character class. There's an isLetter method. Well, just like the isLetter, if we go back there, there is an is, I was going to say isNumber. That's not actually what it's called. It's called isDigit. Okay, let's check to see. Yes, this is, I'll say number now instead. Number, and then we can instead use the isDigit method. is it a digit? Okay, a Z is not a number. What about a question mark? No, that's not a number either. What if we put a 1? Well, now this is we're returned to true from this method because 1 is a digit, and so then it takes that path in our if statement and says, yes, this is a digit. In fact, we could go one step further than this and just say system.out.println character, which is the name of the class, is digit ch. Okay, so we're going to pass it our variable ch and say, is it a digit? Okay, if we run this, then it's going to say true, it is a digit. That's what we're actually getting back, is a true. Okay, what if I put in an A? Well, if I put in an A, then the answer is false. That's what we're getting back. And so then that lends itself to our if statement, because what we're getting here, if I do a whole bunch of control Z's here, is a true or a false. If true, then yes, this is a number. Else, no, this isn't a number. And A is not a number. And that's how we get it. Okay, so that's the character class. And again, there's a bunch of helpful methods here. We can check to see if it's uppercase. Is it uppercase? Is it lowercase? We can check to see if it's white space. We can make it uppercase by saying to uppercase or to lowercase. We can make it a string, make it to string. A number of different methods, and we won't go through all of them. This one, it actually is pretty helpful sometimes. Is it a letter or a digit? If letters and digits are the legal things that we can, you know, type into whatever we're doing when we're trying to eliminate, you know, the dollar sign or the percentage sign or the question marks, then we can check to see, is it a letter or a digit? And if it is, we'll get back a true. And by the way, I just noticed this is kind of off topic, but there's these deprecated bolded, deprecated messages on some of these methods, which means they're old methods that have been replaced by newer methods. So there's still information about them, but eventually these will be phased out completely. All right, well, I think you get the point there, and hopefully you're getting a good feel for these pre-built methods. Again, they're classes that have been built and made available for us to complete these tasks that maybe otherwise we couldn't complete or it would be difficult for us to complete. It's kind of the whole purpose is to make our lives easier, right? And we all like that. Okay, well, hopefully that's helpful. And I'm trying to think of something profound to say, and I've got nothing at all. So I'll just go ahead and end with that. Spencer, out.